Hey guys, today I'm going to be doing some chop testing with this ESEE cleaver. Still getting my head around this. What I'll be doing is smashing it into some permapine or pine 2x4s. So about as uniform as I could get without spending a whole lot of money. So just got five as similar as I could get pine 2x4s. What I'll do is I'll cut each one six times, three times. So six cuts per notch, and I'll do that three times just to sort of so I don't completely munt one up. It's all good. So as scientific as I can get, I just thought you'd be interested in seeing how this thing performs because I'm really interested in it too. So it's heavy. It's heavy, twice as heavy as my axe. Let's see if it chops as well as the axe. I still, I'm interested to see how much leverage I can get off of this thing and also how much that straight edge can deliver in terms of bite. Let's get to it. Well, there you go. That was a pretty decent performance from this big old thing. It's just so heavy. It's like a demolition tool. It just starts breaking the wood apart. As soon as the wood's got enough of a bite taken out of it, the weight of it just crashes it apart. So That's what that did. The axe did the same thing, just because of the force that you can generate. Even though the axe is half the weight, you just have that much more energy coming through this lever here. You can really deliver. And the other three did fine as well, to be honest. They're not tools designed for chopping through wood. The Golok's more of a jungle tool. I'd say the axe and probably the cleaver are the ones that are purpose made for it. So, with the ESEE cleaver, not the old hickory cleaver. That thing's for meat, damn it. But yeah, I hope you found that interesting, and I'll see you in the next video. I'll try and cobble together a good enough review of the ESEE cleaver in the coming days. Just trying to work out, just get my head around it, really, because it's a strange one. I'll see you later.